Hey, this is Jeffrey Clemens with another drum break for you. Today we're going to learn how to play a bossa nova, which is a cool and swanky beat to have in your bag of tricks. And so let's listen to a little of the audio. We're going to listen to Jorge Ben play a little bit of Chove Chove. And so let's listen to get an idea of what we're talking about, and then I'll jump on the drums and we'll slow it down and show you how to play it. Okay, something like this. Here we go.
Chove, chuva, chove sem parar. Chove, chuva, chove sem parar. Pois eu vou fazer uma prece pra Deus Nosso Senhor, pra chuva parar de molhar o meu divino amor.
All right, so there's a little bit of that cool, swanky South American bossa nova sound. Let's jump on over to the drums and I'll play it, and then we'll show you how to play it too. Okay, here we go. Okay, where's my accoutrements? Okay, so here's what's going on here. We're gonna play a brush in the right hand, and we're gonna count 16th notes. One. Two, one, two, three, four, one, e, and a, two, e, and a, three, e, and a, four, e, and a, one, e, and a, two, e, and a, three, e, and a, four, e, and a, one. Pretty simple. You just want to make sure that you can play not too fast, and you want to play real even 16th notes. If you want to sort of shuffle or swing them a little bit so they sound like this, one, e, and a, two, e, and a, three, e, and a, four, e, and a, one. Even better. The left hand, we're going to take a stick and turn it over, and we're going to play a cross stick. Most of you might be advanced if you're watching any of my lessons, but for the beginners, let's just explain this for a second. In order to play a good cross stick, you want to put the stick down backwards with the fat end, and the end that usually goes in your hand is going to cross, you're going to lay it on the drum with about 2 inches of the stick hanging off the edge, so you can get kind of a clicky sound when you so you want to lift the stick and then click it down on the rim. Now, in order to get a good sound from this, you want to consistently hit the stick in the same place on the rim. You don't want to be moving the stick up and backwards because you're going to get inconsistent tones. You want to just find the sweet spot, get a nice fat click out of it. And the other thing you need to know is if you gently, you're going to hold the stick essentially with your forefinger and thumb, and then you're going to gently put your other fingers onto the head of the snare drum head, as well as you can rest the rest of your palm gently on the drum. This mutes the drum so you get this sound, as opposed to if your hand was up in the air, you would get this sound, which is kind of a little bit brash for what we're going to do here. So you want to mute the sound with your fingers and the rest of your hand. This hand is going to play something like, it's going to play this. One E and a, two E and a, three E and a, four E and a, one E and a, two E and a, three E and a, four E and a, one. You put those together, you get one, two, a, one, two, three, four, one E and a, two E and a, three E and a, four E and a, one E. The feet are going to play a kind of a simple pattern, but if you're not used to it, it can seem confusing. The kicks are going to have a little pickup when we count in. They're going to play four E and a one, then a two, a three, a four, a one E and a two E and a three E and a four E and a and a two E and a three E and a four E and a one. The hi-hat is sort of going to counter that in a call and answer type of thing, playing on all the ands, counting something like this. So when you count in, you're going to have a pickup. The first thing you play is four E and a one. So that's the a of four and then the first beat on one. two, a one, two, three, and a one. You put that all together, and you're going to get something like this. One, two, one, two, three, and thanks for checking me out. See you on another drum break soon. Thank you.